So try out next question, this question, 2 minutes. Very good, Shanto. So now we are having enough answers. So let's move further and discuss this question. Very good, Amulya. So let's here discuss this question. Whenever you see questions, trap here is here, distinct positive integers. Please be focused whatever they are saying in question. In a hurry, we will not think of distinct positive integers and mark the answer. So distinct positive integers, right? They are clearly mentioned here. So let's move further and first simplify this question. It looks slightly weird to me. A by B divide by C, what they are trying to say, I'm not able to understand. Just simplify it. So when you simplify it, ultimately my question is what is A divide by BC is integer, right? This question they're asking. This is integer. Now it is very easy because now I can see. Now look at the first statement. They are saying A by C is equal to 3. Let's put A by C is equal to 3 here. We know A by C here, right? This number. A by C is equal to 3. So we can say it comes out to be 3 by B. Now question is what? Is 3 by B integer? This question they're asking. Is 3 by B integer? Now when 3 by B integer they're asking here, now it depends. B is 3 or B is 2? When B is 3, yes, it is an integer. If B is 2, no, it is not an integer. So we are getting clear yes and no. First statement immediately out from here. Right? We are getting clear yes and no from here. So first statement is immediately out here. Now, let's move further. So I hope you understood how we can take it out first statement. A by C was given 3. So in the place of this number, I can write down like this. 1 by B into A by C. And A by C is given to us 3. We can write down 3 into 1 by B, which is 3 by B. Now, it depends over B. B is 3, it's an integer. If B is not 3, it is not an integer. So, first statement is not sufficient to answer my question. Look at the second statement. They are saying A is equal to B plus C. Let's put here. If A is equal to B plus C, we can see B plus C divided by BC, right? Which we can also simplify here. We can say from here, this is 1 by C plus 1 by B. Is this an integer? Now it depends, my friend. When C is equal to B is equal to 1, yes, it is an integer. If I say C is equal to B is equal to 1, it is an integer. Or if I say C is equal to B is equal to 2, it is an integer. But problem is here. It is clearly given to you, these are distinct positive integer. That means what is given to you? B cannot be equal to C. So when B cannot be equal to C, we can immediately say you cannot take these values. When you cannot take these values, we cannot write down BB, right? It is not possible you put any number here. These numbers will never end up with an integer. Because when they're positive integers, this summation will never end up with any integer. See here, how we can confidently say, because you can think of, if I say 1 by 3 plus 1 by 5, do you think it's an integer? Can never be an integer, right? It is integer only in two cases when both of them are equal, as well as both of them are either 1, 1 or 2, 2. Otherwise, it can never be an integer. So immediately we can say from here, when we cannot take 1, 1, 2 because a statement is mentioned in the question, then definitely we are getting, is this number integer? No, it is not integer. Why? Because B and C are distinct numbers, and when we are taking distinct numbers, then it will never end up with an integer. No from here. The question is B. And most of you answer this question right. Good Venkatesh, you are learning. Ankit, Amulya, very good. You people answer this question, so you are be focused about this. So in hurry, what exactly you do when you're solving this question, I'm 100% sure you will eliminate statement 1. But in hurry, when you are doing, you think of immediately, oh, if it is 1, 1, or it can be equal, if it is not, then it cannot be, then you immediately eliminate answer statement 2. So what you did mistake, you forget about what was mentioned in question itself. So do never forget, do put focus whatever is mentioned in the question itself. So this we understood from this question. So learning what was, most of the time they will give you different integers in paper. I have seen multiple times they give you different integers in paper, and that's how they try to play with you, because when you are reading the statement, you are not able to recall what is given in first statement or what is given in the question itself. So please do remember when this word comes, different integers. Let's move further and look at this basic question here. Answer for this question is B for Bangalore. Yes, Varun. Yeah, is B, because from statement B or statement 2, we got to know, no, it cannot be an integer, Varun. Right? Because 1 by C, when we are writing 1 by C plus 1 by B, it will be an integer only when C is equal to B is equal to 1, or C is equal to B is equal to 2. And because of the statement here, we cannot take this. That's why these numbers are distinct, and when these numbers are distinct, these numbers summation, this summation cannot be an integer. So we got clear no from here, right? This is yes no question. Is A divided by BC an integer? No, it is not.